there for what, a few minutes of time, that I stand before you, that I could just let myself get out of the way.
Lord, you bless.
I could just let the Lord use me for a minute of time. The Lord has blessed me in so many ways that I feel that I owe him my entire life.
Yeah, yes, sir. Yeah, it's true.
I feel awful empty this morning in my own self.
Lord, Lord.
But yet my spirit inside of me says is willing. It seems that I came to the Lord in as somewhat of a young person, about my senior year in school. And I struggled with a lot of things with my friends. Would they still like me? Would I have friends? What would take place? It seems like the devil, he has ways of deceiving us. No matter where we're at in life, no matter what's going on, whether you're young or whether you're old, one place in the book of Peter, he begins to talk about that the Lord, he don't want none to perish, but that all should come to repentance. Just pray for me for a minute of time.
Lord, to bless.
This morning, brother, you talk about your brother and how fast things change and how fast that our lives here on earth can change, Papa. And most of the time, change is not easy for us. It's not something that we welcome. It's hard. One time back in the Garden of Eden, when the Lord, he set Adam and Eve in the garden there, Elisha, and no doubt their lives, it was absolute bliss, no doubt, living in the garden.
Yeah.
Brother, I don't think you can even to imagine the when they would go out and work in the garden there and take care of it with all the animals round about. Understanding Eve, she was called the mother of all things, brother. Her and Adam, they lived there in the garden. And everything was perfect. I'm Elisha, but you know what? There was a little serpent there. Brother, that came to that woman and he said, that tree over there, you see how pretty it is.
Yeah.
And you know what Eve said to him? She said, the Lord, he said, we can eat of all things in this garden here. But that tree over there, he said, we can't eat of that tree. The day that we eat of it, we'll surely die. I hope for a minute of time that I could just settle my skills and I could preach for a minute because you see, no doubt, that's the way that I found myself in this life here when I was just a young man. No doubt, everything seemed perfect in my life at one time. When I was a young boy growing up, everything was good. But you know what? Something entered in, brother, to me to where that I found that I wasn't just right. You see, when that devil began to tempt me, to eat of that tree, brother. He deceived her and told her that it was good. Oh God, he surely won't kill you if you eat of that tree, but you know what'll happen? You'll become as wise as God, and you'll know as much as God knows. Well, he deceived Eve, and she ate of that tree, and she took to her husband, and she fed it to him too. Oh, you know what? The Bible says, Joe, their eyes was open, the good and evil there, and they saw their own nakedness, brother. And it said that Adam, he was ashamed, brother. No doubt, one time about 16 and a half years old, 17 years old, sitting in the little back of a little church house up in Michigan, I found myself with my head hung down, ashamed of what God looked down and saw upon me. And no doubt, just like Adam and Eve, back in that garden, you know what they heard, Michael? They heard the voice of God coming through the pool of the garden there. And it said, Adam hid himself because he was ashamed. And he said, I heard your voice, Lord, calling me. He says, Adam, where are you? I'm hiding, Lord, behind this tree because I'm naked. And he said, who told you that you're naked? You know what? I wish to God that each person here that's never repented could find themselves naked in front of the Lord. Brother, it takes that condemnation, that feeling of shame, that you would come down upon your knees and repent.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's what it takes. Find yourself at a place where that you're so ashamed in front of the Lord.
That's right.
But you know what? I thank God that that's not the end. Because the Lord, he already had it in store, Joe. He already had a covering made.
Yeah.
Back when they were making the entire world, the earth, the Lord said, let us make man in our own image. Brother, the answer to the ashamedness, to the condemnation that you feel down inside, the answer was already there in the beginning. And you know, this man that I'm talking about, this covering, Jesus Christ, well, Joe, when I found myself down beside my bed about 1 o'clock in the morning, you see, when I was ashamed, when I found myself naked in front of the Lord, and I lay there beside my bed and cried out to him, I didn't even know how to pray or what to say, brother. You did a good job there this morning. You know what? I found myself down beside my bed, crying out unto God, yeah, saying, Lord, I just wanted heaven to be my home, but I find myself, I'm not afraid to go to sleep. I find myself afraid to lay down and close my eyes, because I don't feel like heaven's gonna be my home. You know what? After praying many times, after feeling like I couldn't get no prayers through, after finding out that I couldn't even, seemed like I couldn't even talk to the Lord, I had a little bit of fire. Brother Larry, it seemed like it was the world to me. But you know what? I was about 16 and a half, 17 years old. I didn't have no bills. I lived in mom and dad's basement there. I didn't even have nothing to worry about. But I felt like I held that dirt bike so high, brother. Oh, well, you know what? When I was sitting in the back of church there, Darrell was up preaching, and he said, you gotta make the Lord first in your Well, you can't have nothing standing in front. You know what? I go home, I think about that all night long, and I say, well, Lord, I'll sell this dirt bike if that's what you want. God, I'll give it all to you. And you know what? Brother, there beside my bed that night, about midnight, I felt something I've never felt before. I felt the covering come upon this nakedness, brother, and it was the blood of his son. He said, oh, Chad, you see, my son, he already hung on a cross, and he died.
All right, so that worked. So that you can have life.
He never made me sell my dirt bike. But he wanted me in my heart to give up everything in my life and put the Lord first. My greatest prayer is that all would come to repentance and find the Lord before it's too late.
Yes.
We don't know how fast things are going to change. We think that the old are going to die first and the young will die later on. That's not how it works.
No.
We've heard Michael preach about burying little babies. So it's not in our mind we get things backwards. I love each one of you. I'm going to give way and let these brothers come on.
Done well.
Come on, brothers. Hallelujah.